I wish to inform you of some more positive changes to come. First of all, we are determined to grow this bank to become a billion-dollar strong national financial institution headquartered right here on the south side of Chicago. Many of you know about mobile wallets, such as what Zelle provides. In July of this year, 2018, we will introduce our own mobile banking wallet product called Pay Global. We plan to work hard to convince merchants in this community, the store around the corner, restaurants such as Peaches, which is not too far from here, Mariano's and the rest, to accept this product so that you do not have to carry cash with you. And you know what I always say about Mr. Chase. Now, Mr. Chase may have Zelle, but ISF Bank will have Pay Global. And our product, I tell you, you will find is better than that of Mr. Chase. We are currently a federally regulated national thrift. We will change this to become a federally regulated national bank with branches in Wisconsin, Virginia, Georgia, Massachusetts, Maryland, New York, and Washington, D.C. to begin with. But the headquarters will remain right here on the south side of Chicago. And we are about to start the process to acquire trust powers so that we can provide additional services within this community. And I am proud about what I'm about to tell you, that we have decided to give ISF Bank a boost by rebranding it. But first, a bit of history. You see, the Illinois Service Federal Savings and Loan Association has gone through mergers and some acquisitions. 1976, it acquired Service Federal Savings and Loans Association. Many people don't know that. In 1982, it acquired Morgan Park Savings and Loan Association. In 2011, changed primary regulatory agency from the Office of Thrift Supervision to the Comptroller of the Currency. 2014, we changed organization type to become a mutual savings bank. And then in 2016, we changed organization type again to become a stock savings bank. Now, a well-known personality has said that the only thing constant in life is change. So we're about to change once again. And our bank and our family has developed an internationally known banking brand called GN Bank, which started off as a savings and loans company and has grown to become an international bank with more than 300 branches and in multiple countries. Every now and then, some people ask me, well, what's going to happen to this little bank on the south side of Chicago? Because they just look at the bank and say, well, it doesn't have anything to lean on. Well, we're about to change that, because we do have a strong financial institution GN Bank with international connections that we are about to link ISF to. And we believe the time has come to bring the brand that we know here to Chicago and give assurances to everybody who's been asking us questions that this bank is here to stay. And one of the important elements that we are also determined that the ownership will remain African American. Accordingly, we have sought the approval of the Office of the Comptroller of Currency, and they have given their approval for us to change the name of ISF Bank to GN Bank. And this change will take effect in July. Now, let me tell you some of the things that will come. First of all, we will have no fear that we will lack additional capital as the bank grows, because our GN Bank family will be able to provide the funds that this bank needs to continue to grow. We also have personnel. We have our own software. We have all the kinds of support and everything that this bank needs to compete. To compete not just on the local front, not just on the national front, but also on the international front. So if I go to my friend, Mr. Chase, there is nothing Mr. Chase can put on the table that we cannot master. And so this will happen in July. And one of the things that you're going to see, I've talked about Pay Global. And Pay Global, we have many people in our community who do not have bank accounts. Well, this Pay Global product is going to make it possible for them not to carry cash and for them to do business, to keep their money safe, and to do many, many, many other things. And as part of this change, we'd like to introduce something a bit different. For new money, we're now about to offer what we call a premium account that will pay 1.8% interest. Now, with everything it says, terms and conditions apply. So terms and conditions will apply. But that is where we're going. And I believe that many of you, when you come to the bank in a few weeks, you will see something different. You will see a new attitude, you will see new products, and you see a new dedication to ensuring that this bank not only stays, but thrives and becomes the best that we can make it. And so on behalf of the shareholders, let me thank the members of the board of directors for their diligent work. And I know some of you know the members of the board of directors, but if they can please stand so we can appreciate them. There's Joe Moore. There's Francis Bauer. There's Lisa Fink. There's Carol Wood. John Davidson.